Experimental self-driving vehicles are taking to our streets, skies, and seas, powered by artificial intelligence. They might transport you around cities, grow your food, or deliver packages to your doorstep. They could reveal hidden glimpses of the world around you, and even save lives. They are designed to outperform humans at specialized tasks in very specific environments, but they are not quite ready to take full control. Training their AI to interact safely with us in our complex and unpredictable world is still a significant challenge. Deciding how and whether they should be used is another. Self-driving vehicles use sensors and artificial intelligence, or AI. AI is what enables self-driving vehicles to react in unpredictable situations. This is an early example of British self-driving technology. The car was modified by the Road Research Laboratory, which added an experimental automatic steering system. The experiments were carried out on a specially adapted test track. When the automatic steering mode was engaged, the driver could take their hands off the wheel. This car was a prototype and was never commercially produced. At the time, researchers estimated such systems could allow 50% more cars to drive on the roads, while reducing accident rates. Today, pods are being used to help carry passengers through airports and car parks. This is an example that researchers are testing in Greenwich, where it could soon take visitors on a scenic journey around the peninsula. Quiet and fully electric, it's meant to operate in public spaces alongside pedestrians, cyclists, and animals. Self-driving technology is being developed for many types of land vehicles, from cars and trucks to military supply vehicles and robots that make deliveries and farm crops. Tom is the first prototype developed by the small robot company. It can decide what route to take around a field, photograph crops, and tag their position on a map. It works alongside Dick and Harry, which pull weeds and water the crops. This data is sent to an artificial intelligence-driven control system called Wilma. Technology developers argue self-driving vehicles could make journeys faster, safer, and more sustainable. But some environments, such as busy cities, are highly unpredictable and would need significant modifications to enable self-driving technology. Your behaviour might have to change too. Remote-controlled drones, piloted by human operators, have been around for decades. Now, experimental drones that fly themselves are taking to the skies. Programming drones to fly on their own allows human operators to use many at a time and send them where humans cannot go. As young boys in Afghanistan, brothers Masood and Mahmoud Hassani would make and race wind-powered toys. Today, their goal is to create an unmanned demining system that could clear the world's landmines within 10 years. Masood first created the Mine Kafon Ball in 2011. Roughly the height and weight of a person, the full-sized art piece catches enough wind to roll it over minefields, detonating hidden landmines as it goes. Many types of self-driving water vehicles are in development, from small ships that form footbridges on demand to massive cargo ships and military vessels that hunt for hidden submarines. Some are being developed to explore challenging deep ocean environments and beneath sea ice in polar regions. In these extreme places, far beyond the limits of human endurance and communication, researchers must rely on these vehicles to take full control over their missions. We know more about the surface of Mars than our ocean floor. These technologies could help make our world a smaller place. They might also help us protect it. This is a two-thirds scale model of the Autosub long-range vehicles. Engineers at the National Oceanography Centre have developed the ALR fleet to explore the deep ocean and beneath polar ice. collecting data on the causes and impacts of climate change. Each ALR is equipped with intelligent navigation systems to ensure they can operate independently for months at a time, up to 6,000 meters underwater and 2,000 kilometers away, before returning safely with valuable data. Driverless cars have been a dream for decades, but until now have been mostly science fiction. This technology is developing quickly, and in the coming years, we will increasingly see driverless cars and drones in our public spaces. When that happens, we will all have decisions to make about how we think these vehicles should be used. And all of this will raise the question, who is in control?